Hello, and welcome to the Genre Traveler Podcast, episode number 33. This is your host, Karma Spence, the Genre Traveler. Today, I'm chatting with Nick Brown, author of the Werewolf for Hire series. Welcome to the Genre Traveler Podcast, Nick.
Karma, thank you so much for having me on. I'm really excited to be on the Genre Traveler Podcast. The series follows he's a werewolf detective, and his name's Michael Warren. And basically, I got tired of reading werewolf books and seeing werewolf movies where everybody feels, oh, it's a curse, I'm cursed, I don't like being a werewolf. You know, I wanted somebody who enjoyed being a werewolf and, you know, interacted in from that perspective. And I did take a bit of a different spin on the werewolf idea for this. It's still, you know, the traditional, hey, he's a werewolf, he turns into a full wolf, but he controls it. And so he can kind of control how far into a wolf he becomes. So he can turn into something that looks sort of like the werewolves in Dog Soldiers, if you're familiar with that movie. And then, or he can become a full-on wolf. And Silver, instead of being instantly fatal, werewolves, in my perception of them, however you want to say it, they are able to heal incredibly fast. But if they're wounded with Silver, their healing factor doesn't work. So that's where I kind of use that to tie in where the idea of Silver came from as a way to kill werewolves. Because if you shoot him with a regular bullet, he can recover pretty quickly. But if you shoot him with a silver bullet, well, he's just like anybody else who's shot. I love horror. I just love, you know, the different aspects of horror movies, and I was always a big fan of the Universal monster movies, especially Lon Chaney's, you know, The Wolfman, the original. That aspect, you know, it is a curse in that, but at the same time, I just found the idea of becoming a wolf, you know, this animal side of somebody coming out, just to be fascinating, and that's always been one of my favorite types of movies. And of course, there's, you know, American Werewolf in London, and again, that's another one of the films where it's a curse. Then you have films like The Howling, where, you know, you have this entire culture of werewolves and how they interact and how they try to fit into society. And so I just think that's a really interesting idea. And plus, I like the idea that you can be a normal person on the outside and be a monster on the inside